Greetings from the Quality Circle Forum of India, Surat Chapter. The Quality Circle Forum of India recognizes as an institution representing the Quality Circle movement in India and has represented the country in several international forums. The QCFI is a non-profit and non-political organization that propagates the quality concepts through training and annual conventions at regional, national, as well as international levels. QCFI has 33 chapters, 2 sub-chapters, and 3 centers in all over India, which are engaged in such a nation-building activity. QCFI has a main strength of in-house training programs and orientation programs. The QCFI Surat chapter. It has 33 organizational members, 50 individual life members, and many associate members. Some of the leading organizations like L&T, Reliance, Cripco, Adani, Donier, and Textile Processors are the active members of QCFI Surat chapter. It has organized more than 22 training and seminar on the various topics of the quality concepts, which do also include the in-house training programs. The QCFI Surat chapter has organizes the conventions on the safety concepts at Sarsana Convention Centers, along with the SGPC Surat in Energy Expo 2017. It has organized the seminar on enhancing productivity and competitive advantage through employment relations, a paradigm shift at Oro University, Surat. It has also organized the 2 annual chapter convention on the quality circles and aligned quality concept. The QCFI Surat chapter has played a vital role in organizing the 6th National Conclave on 5S at Surat, along with the QCFI headquarters and Ankleshwar chapter. It has also organized the 1st National Level Safety Convention. Mr. L.K. Dungrani, who is the chairman at QCFI Surat chapter, Dr. Latesh Chaudhary, Mr. Rajbir Singh Siani, Dr. Suresh Sharma are the vice chairman at QCFI Surat chapter. Mr. Pankaj Chawda, the secretary member, Mr. Ashish Desai, joint secretary member, Mr. Jitendra Vyas, joint secretary member, Mr. Anil Krishali, the treasurer, Mr. Rakesh Patel, joint treasurer, Dr. D.V. Bhatt, Mr. Chirag Desai, Mr. Chintan Parmar, Surinder Kaur Chaudhary, Mr. Varun Surani are the governing council member at Quality Control Forum of India, Surat chapter. If we implement the quality concept at any institute or organization, that involves the first stage of assessment, which also includes the further steps of survey of the organization, discuss the findings and formulate the action plan, then conduct the initial in-house training program for the top and senior executive members, then organize the intensive in-house training program for the employee of the various department. It is ensured that the full interaction with the all executive members and the employee of the various department during this training sessions. The second stage is of implementation, in that the first stage involves of take a major problem as the project, then launch the quality concepts, implement the need-based aligned quality concepts like 5S, Kaizen, JIT, TPM, SMED, ISO 40000, ISO 9000, etc. And finally, on the maturity, prepare the organization for the quality awards. QCFI has get the participation from the various industries, banks, hospitals, hotels, schools, homes, and other organizations as well. The QCFI has organized the training program for the all level organizations as per the requirement of the institute or organization. It organizes the programs in English, Hindi, and Gujarati language based on the requirement. The benefit or the advantage of the quality concept in a particular organization is to ensure the harmony, effective teamwork, job satisfaction, problem solving capacity, better communication, self-development, leadership development, safety awareness and housekeeping, productivity improvement, team building, participation, and self-discipline. These are the some pictures of the seminar on quality concept in improving the energy efficiency in association with SGPC. One day convection at Oro University, Surat. The first annual convection of QCFI Surat chapter. Sixth National Conclave on the 5S by Quality Circle Forum of India at Oro University, Surat. National Level Safety Convention. The Quality Circle Forum of India, Surat chapter, has started a QCFI student wing at R.N.G. Patel Institute of Technology College, Bardoli, and around 50 students from the different engineering field registered under that. The purpose of this student wing is to accelerate the quality concepts and tools with the curriculum. As a result of that, the all advantage of the quality concept will get benefit for the student. The Quality Circle Forum of India, Surat chapter, heartily invite you for a first ever virtual e-convention on the quality concepts, CCQC 2020. The theme for this convention is Developing Self-Reliant India Through the Quality Concepts. The major top giant industry will present the case study. Thank you for your participation.
Assist, we can start. Latesh sir.
Yes.
Hello. Yes sir. Video is over sir. We can start the further proceedings.
Once again, very good afternoon to all. After getting the entire information from the video, let us start the today's e-convention with the name of Almighty God. So let us start with the stuti of Ganesha. Vakratund Mahakaya Surya Koti Sama Prabha Nirvighnam Kurume Deva Sarvakarya Su Sarvada शुभ कार्य सु सर्वदा.
So once again, very good afternoon, one and all present over here. So on this beautiful afternoon, I myself, Ashish Desai, Joint Secretary Surat Chapter, on behalf of entire family of QCFI and QCFI Surat Chapter, warmly welcome you all for chapter's third and first virtual e-chapter convention on quality concepts 2020 due to current situation raised by COVID-19. So once again, I warmly welcome one and all present on the screen and off the screen. So friends, as far as the chapter tradition is concerned, hospitality is inarguably one of the defining quality of chapter. Our measurable hearts do become immeasurable when our guests are around us. Today, as we specially celebrate this landmark, our hearts are inspired with joy on your readiness to be with us. So today, dear guests present on and off the screen, you are so precious to us. Thus, to formally welcome the gathering, may I now invite Mr. L.K. Dungrani, the chairman of QCFI chapter, on the screen for welcoming the gathering. Mr. L.K. Dungrani, sir, over to you.
Dungrani sahib, unmute che. Unmute che. Karun? Are pane? Bolo bolo.
Hello. Okay. Ha.
Yes, sir.
Good afternoon.
Yes,
sir. Good afternoon.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon.
Honorable Chief Guest Alok Sarkar. My voice is audible.
Yes, sir.
My voice is audible. Okay. Good afternoon and namaskar. Honorable Chief Guest Mr. Alok Sarkar, Chief Executive and Maritime Director, L&T MHPS Turbine Generator Private Limited, Surat. Today's guest of honor and my friend Mr. Kamlesh Bhai Udani, ex-executive director, Technical and Production, Technical and Pharmaceutical Limited, Ankleshwar. All the participants and delegates invited from the different industries, all governing council members of QCFI Surat, ladies and gentlemen. I, the L.K. Dungrani, Chairman, Quality Circle Forum of India, Surat Chapter, Surat, heartily welcome you all from bottom of my heart and also on behalf of the entire QCFI family. I am delighted to welcome on this August gathering the first virtual chapter convention on quality concept CCQC 2020 for the Surat chapter, owing to the current situation of Corona-19 pandemic, we are organizing a convention for the safety reason. My dear friends, today we have got total 42 teams for this convention. Out of 42, 30 teams for the QC quality controls and 7 teams for EQC and 7 from the students. They all are representing today. Today there will be 20 teams will represent in a different slot, in a 3 slots. There are 6 judges will evaluate the situation, and tomorrow again there will be a 17 teams, or 42 teams, including the student team, will be evaluated. Details of our Surat chapter is already you have seen in the videos. I will not take much more time. Once again, let me conclude my speech with the words of William A. Foster. Quality is never an accident. It is always the result of high intention, sincere effort, intelligent direction, and skillful execution. It represents the wise choice of many alternatives. Once again, Jai Hind, Jai Jai Garvi Gujarat, and best wishes to all the teams who are participating in the our CCQC Convention 2020. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat. Thank you, Mr. Ashish.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, Chairman Ji, for your kind words of welcome that will make our guests feel at home here. So once again, thank you very much, sir. Now, let me start with the quote of Mr. John Quincy Adams. He said that if your action inspire others to dream more, learn more, and become more, you are a leader. So today at this juncture, I would like to attribute this proverb to our guest of honor and the chief guest, because their valuable past makes them important today, and it will make an impact on future generation. So, as I already told you that welcoming is the noblest act of any function, now I request the vice chairman of the chapter and the principal of RNG PIT, Dr. Latesh Chaudhary sir, to give a brief introduction about our today's guest of honor and welcoming him with your kind words, sir. Please.
Yeah, thank you, Ashish. Good afternoon, all. On behalf of QCFI Surat chapter, I welcome today's guest of honor, Mr. Kamlesh Udani, in a virtual convention on quality concepts, CCQC 2020, organized by QCFI Surat chapter on the theme Developing Self-Reliant India Through Quality Concepts. It is my pleasure to introduce Mr. Kamlesh Udani. He was Executive Director of JB Chemicals and Pharmaceuticals Limited, Ankleshwar. He is associated with various organizations, professional societies, industrial associations, and hospitals. Like, he is trustee of Ankleshwar Industrial Development Society and Sardar Patel Hospital, Ankleshwar, and many other trusts. He was past president of Ankleshwar Industries Association, Bharuch District Management Association, Rotary Club of Bharuch, Indian Drugs Manufacturers Association, Gujarat State Board. Is founder chairman of Mahavir International Bharuch, Jain Social Group Bharuch, Bharuch Citizens Council Bharuch. He has traveled widely in India and abroad. He has also visited Astrakhan in July 2006, a business delegation of Government of Gujarat to sign the Astrakhan Treaty. So once again, I welcome you, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you very much, guest of honor, Mr. Kamlesh Udani, sir. Now, sir, we know that today we have with us Mr. Kamlesh Udani, have an eminent and intellectual personality in the person who has an uncanny ability to win the heart of everyone he meets with his pleasant demeanor. Sir, we also got lot of words from for you and for your side from our beloved chairman, Mr. L.K. Dungrani, sir. So, sir, please share your wisdom with us. Over to Mr. Kamlesh Udani, sir.
Okay. Thank you. First of all, I want to thank Dr. Latesh Chaudhary ji for a very kind introduction. And many thanks to Dugrani Sahib, whom I know for last more than 2.5 decades. He, being a government officer, after retirement, normally they become more dull. But in his case, it is the reverse. He has become more active and he is organizing various programs through, and QCFI, we have seen the activities. So I congratulate you, Dugrani Sahib, for keeping QCFI alive and active in Surat. And I'm sure you will bring many more laurels to QCFI chapter. In fact, he has been asking me to join various other programs, but unfortunately, I missed the earlier one. Sorry, sir. But today I'm making up. So I hope you will excuse me for earlier mishaps. I'm very happy that we have Alok Sarkar ji as our chief guest. Chirag bhai, can you show the slide, if possible? Otherwise, it's fine if you cannot. Alok Sarkar ji represents company L&T. And L&T is known for quality. Next. Yeah. L&T started as switchgear company, but went into cement, heavy engineering, nuclear, and so many other fields, including turbines and other projects. And wherever it has gone, the quality has been landmark. The name and the stamp of L&T indicates that it is quality. How it is achieved? I think we will be benefited from the talk from Mr. Sarkar. Next. I want to start with a little story of the what happened in Japan. Japan, you know, is a country where the seafood is very popular. And as the population grew and went, the fishes, getting fishes were difficult. So over a period of time, they found out more vehicles, more bigger boats and all that to bring fishes. But ultimately, when they get the fishes from the deep sea, the taste was very different than the normal fish. So they put up a very big tank and put the fish into it and sweet water and all that, and tried to bring the fish to the, but somehow they failed miserably. The taste of the fish was different. So finally somebody came out with an idea, and in the tank they put a small shark. Now this small shark fish was eating few fishes, but because of that, the entire fish community in the tank was remaining alive and agile because they wanted to save themselves. So this made all the fishes, when they reached the shore, they were very fresh and active and alive. And so the taste was again brought back to the fish food. Now, this is very similar to us also, because such programs which QCFI keeps on for the people in the industry, this becomes a small shark kind of a thing which reminds them that they what they are supposed to do, what they will be doing, is very important for the country. And if you want to make India self-reliant and go into many fields, like now the we are going into defense ministry, production, and so many fields. So these quality concepts are very important, and and everyone has to remain alive and agile till the last moment working in the industry. And this example is very similar to keep human being also active. So this, with this small, I would like to quote the man thrives, oddly enough, only in the presence of a challenging environment. So challenging environment is needed. And today, I think our country is passing through a great challenge. It may be pandemic or it may be economic crisis, but we'll have to be more active and agile, active to make the country self-reliant. And as George Bernard Shaw says, satisfaction is there. So we should not be satisfied with what we are doing or what we had 5,000 years back. India was golden India and all that. It is no good. We need to be active and agile. Next. So quality concepts have been developed, and over a period of time, we, as all of you know, I don't have to repeat this, the Japanese automobile industry started, and many other countries started in Japan, and it has spread all over the world. Then the Six Sigma came, and Kaizen was in Japan, and so many other concepts which have been used. But ultimately, we all know that quality cannot be compromised, and quality is way of life. Here I am reminded of another example. A American, maybe Ford or General Motors, I don't remember, but one of the company placed an order of 1 million component to Japanese company, and said that when you supply, 0.2% of defective parts will be acceptable. So Japanese company made the parts, and 0.2% defective parts. So they were wondering what to do and how to do. And finally, they put 0.2% of defective parts and sent it. And the US company was very happy. But when they called up Japanese counterpart, the Japanese said that it was very difficult for us to make that 0.2% defective parts. We can't make defective parts. So that is the quality. That is the concept of quality. And this is true for Japanese. It can be true for all our companies across the world. And particularly India is now getting into newer era of self-reliant India. So the quality is going to be the most important aspect. And we cannot compromise. It should be way of life. Next point. Next, Chirag bhai. So how do we build this quality? One of the challenges is to bring in quality culture in the organization. The Dumrani Sahib cannot do everything in QCFI, which is the best, but it has to be a team built. The entire culture of QCFI or entire culture in the organization. L&T Alok Sarkarji cannot do everything, but it's a culture in the L&T organization or in any other company, which makes the quality to really happen in the product and the processes. And I would like to share with you what has happened in pharmaceutical industry, because I worked in 41 years in pharma, so I know only pharmaceuticals. So how the quality concept has evolved in the pharma, and how the quality culture is built into the products, because it is going to human being, and not a single tablet or not a single injectable can be compromised. So how the pharma industry has grown and how the quality concept has been evolved and how the quality culture is built, probably I'd like to share that few points with you. Next. Next, Chirakbhai. See, the in 60s and 70s, the pharmaceutical companies, and which would be true for any other industry, that you produce a batch, and out of that 10, 20 samples you test, and if everything is okay, you supply the good. But there have been many mishaps. The quality in between was a compromise, or there have been contamination, patients died, and all that. And over a period of time, the entire concept of quality assurance was evolved in pharmaceutical industry. And quality is not the job of a QC person, but quality assurance, which will ensure that it will assure the production lines to be more safe and quality conscious and at achieving the quality norms. Next point. From that day, the initial started with the production and stores, but now today, it starts right from the designing of the product, R&D stage, vendors, supply chain, and up to the distribution and the final, up to the consumer level, and then you do the market research. Pharmacovigilance, we call it. So we try to cover the entire patient community, and if there are any reactions, if there are any compromises happening on the because of the product. So this, the entire change of quality management system has changed from production and stores to, or quality control to, right from designing of the product till the finished product and in the market, how it behaves. So this concept is in pharma, and I'm sure it is applicable to any other industry, and it has to be encompassing the entire gamut of the manufacturing, right from the selection of the designing of the product, vendors, and till the finished product. We have in pharma, the any changes you want to do or any deviation you want to make, there is a mechanism to do that, and there you have to do the risk management. Now this helps us to appreciate the points which are missed out. If one machine is broken, you take the other machine and you believe that it will perform the same, but it may not perform the same. Alok Sarkar Sahib can tell us that one machine on turbine cannot be same, because the tolerance will be different by each machine to machine. Same is for pharmaceutical. And the what we do also in the complaint investigation is the root cause analysis. So now the concept of testing product and releasing is gone. This is what I wanted to emphasize here. Next, please. Next. Now, how do we achieve this? What we have done in our company, in JB Chemicals and Pharmaceutical, I would like to share with you that how do you know the culture, how it is built? There has been a very interesting story which you all might have listened to, that in a room, closed room, few monkeys were put and the banana was hanged. So monkeys would try, there was a ladder also. So monkeys would try to catch the, go on the ladder and catch the banana. But they had put a water shower. So once they put a step on the ladder, there will be water flowing on their head. So over a period of time, the monkeys stopped going up because the water will fall on them, and the monkeys thought getting banana is very difficult. So then the one monkey was replaced, second was replaced, third was replaced, and at one point every monkey was replaced. But the concept that you cannot climb the ladder, and because there will be a water from the top, that continued, and hence no monkeys later on tried to catch the banana. Now this becomes a culture. The original people goes, new comes, but they continue with the practices which earlier was followed. So to avoid this and make everyone very active and agile, what we have done is we have selected the talent from our team, whether it may be production, warehouse, QC, HR, engineering, any other departments, and then given them the opportunity to become the trainer. So, and this we had given them enough training, proper and adequate training, time to time, refreshing them with knowledge like webinars and seminars like this to attend and keep themselves alive and agile, intellectually alive. Second aspect which we started, the senior most person would take a mentorship role for his reportees. If I have 7 reportees, I will take responsibility of 7 people and see that they become as good as me and they should be able to take my position. So there is a second line ready, and second line will make third line ready, and so on and so forth. So this way, they try to propagate the culture in the organization. And fourth point which we have started is the knowledge improvement. Apart from the work that everyone does, there are 5, 6, 7 points which everyone should learn so that their growth happens. It is irrespective whether company gains or not, but the individual should grow, whether in my company or other company. So the knowledge improvement plan was made, shared with them, and they were participating into the entire program. And this was designed for pharmaceutical. I'm sure it can be done for any other industry, but this is basically empowering the employees to become more knowledgeable, more active and participative. Once they are equipped with the knowledge, they can participate, they can share, they can discuss, they can train others. Next. And this has given us a very good result. We have been getting US FDA, which is considered the most difficult, and you might have read in the newspapers that this pharma company has been given ban by the US FDA or warning by the US FDA. So we have been audited every 2 years from 2003 onwards. Till date, we have been not given any warning because of the quality culture that we have built in. So quality is not an act, it's a habit. We don't try to find a fault, find a remedy, and quality is everyone's responsibility. If these few points are taken care, I'm sure India will become self-reliant over a period of time in whatever area the production takes place or marketing happens or development happens, service level. Thank you very much again to entire QCFI team for giving me this opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir, for your thought-provoking process. You are absolutely right that quality should be within. We need to develop a culture to involve the entire society for improving the quality. Definitely, I can share a thought of D. Albert Einstein. He told that without changing our pattern of thought, we will not be able to solve the problems that we create with our current pattern of thoughts. So we need to change the pattern of our thought, and only we can establish a good quality at our industries. Thank you very much, sir, for your thought-provoking message. We will definitely work towards each and every verse which was there in your slide and said by you. Now we are having another personality with us, eminent personality, and I'd like to call our secretary, Mr. Pankaj Chawda, sir, to give a brief introduction about our today's chief guest of this first ECCQC program of Surat chapter. Over to you, Pankaj Chawda, sir.
Good afternoon, everyone. Honorable chief guest and guest of honor, and our chairman and vice chairman on the dais, I am privileged to give introduction of the chief guest, Mr. Alok Sarkar. So Mr. Alok Sarkar is a mechanical engineer from National Institute of Technology. It is known as NIT Durgapur. And he joined Bharat Heavy Electricals Limited, BHEL, one of the a finance company in India in 1981 as an engineer trainee. He worked there extensively in manufacturing of turbines and generators and technical support to site activities during his 27 years of career in BHEL. In 2008, he moved to L&T MHI Turbine Generators Private Limited. Now it is known as L&T MHPS Turbine Generators Private Limited, and was instrumental in establishing a greenfield project to manufacture supercritical and ultra supercritical steam turbines and generators at Hazira, Surat. He was involved in recruitment and training of manpower, establishing process, manufacturing processes, and meetings with the MHPS, our joint venture partners, on quality standards. Having worked extensively in manufacturing, methods engineering, procurement, plant engineering, and exposure to commercial activities, he became the vice president and head of operations in 2016. He has taken several initiatives to optimize the cost, to make the product cost competitive, and explore opportunities in spares and services segment. Under his guidance, LMTG, LMT MHPS turbine generator is known as LMTG in short, was able to successfully complete the phased manufacturing program for turbine and generators. And recently, in 17 July 2020, he is appointed as chief executive and full-time director of the LMTG. So we welcome Sarkar Saab for our convention. Over to Ashish.
Pankaj Chawda sir, for the kind brief introduction of our today's chief guest, and I think that a single note is not possible to say about our today's chief guest. Thank you very much, sir, for being with us on behalf of entire team. So it's my great privilege to welcome our chief guest of the day, Mr. Alok Sarkar sir, to enlighten the technocrats and the quality community with your experience and your thought. Please, sir.
Good afternoon. Thanks, Ashish Bhai and Pankaj. Yeah, Dungnani Saab, Dr. Latesh, Kamlesh Ji, all other dignitaries, and especially the participants. It's my privilege and honor to be here, and I thank QCFI Surat chapter and especially Dungnani Saab for having me here.
Thank you.
Actually, we know each other very well. Last few years, and definitely I also wanted to join, and on the other side I cannot say no to Dungnani sir as well, but QCFI is something definitely anytime, any where I would like to join that in any and after such a nice presentation from Kamlesh bhai, if I can say in Gujarati style, anything I say will be very less. It's a nice presentation, Kamlesh ji. You talked about everything about quality circle and its importance. And especially if we see in today's context, where the scenario across the globe, due to pandemic, what has happened, and our government led by Mr. Modi, whatever stand they have taken to become Atma Nirbhar India, this QCFI or the quality of each and every individual need to be improved, and it's very important in this context also. For me, quality is just a simple thing. If we actually, in my entire life, whatever problem come, I normally take it as a very simple thing, because once you make it complex, it's very difficult to resolve the thing. So take it as a simple way. So quality is also same way, because since 80s, then 90s, I have seen how the quality concept of Indian people have changed. In 80s, it was something like chalega. Whatever you do, it's okay. Everything is fine. No problem. Everybody has got that sort of acceptability to anything and everything. In 90s, India opened up. General people of India started seeing things manufactured outside India. and the concept or the quality and the requirement standard, everything started getting changed. If you see the mobile automobile, that is where actually everything started, probably in 83, 84, sometimes when Suzuki came. And before that, you had this Ambassador and that Fiat of Padmini. And how after Maruti, of course, few more came, some just wiped out, and few just remained. And see the quality concept. And luckily, right now I am in LMTG, which is actually a joint venture of L&T, one side, and another side is Japanese company, which is called Mitsubishi Heavy Industries. Part of that, of course, electrical, and part of that is mechanical. So, as Kamlesh ji told, yes, many things actually have come up from Japanese concept. But if you go back to our Indian context, you will find many more things were actually used to be practiced in earlier days, but we never continued it. What is the reason? As such, if you see, we Indians are not so disciplined. In a way, COVID has forced us to become a little bit disciplined. And if you see, even the Asian, barring this Japanese, even Japanese were not so disciplined. When they are devastated in World War, after that, they started doing it. They knew that they are in such a scenario. If they don't become disciplined, and if they don't become self-reliant, if they don't come up with new ideas, if they don't come out with, say, matured quality, they cannot survive. Today, this pandemic has given a real bright chance to India to become a real force economically. India is treated as a good force, but that is politically, not economically. We were third or fourth like this, but today we are, you know, all of us know where we are economically, where we stand. But probably we have got a real opportunity. But that opportunity can be utilized and used only when we think of disciplined way how we can manufacture things fast at the right at the first time. Of course, it has to be dropped down because quality is the demand. People need to ask for it. So it's a top-down approach, definitely. But as Kamlesh ji says, yes, it's a culture that has to be basically bring forward, and then it has to be nurtured properly, and it has to be maintained. So sustainable quality concept and culture has to be maintained in each and every context, each and every place. Quality circle concept is a part of life. It is not related to any particular industry or anything. As Kamlesh ji was telling, whether it is for drug or pharmaceutical industries, or it is for automobile industries, or like us, heavy industries, concept remains same. You make certain things, you make some fault or non-conformities, you have to have the same approach for the root cause analysis. Probably the tools to be used can be changed based on the requirements. But even for personal life also, the same concept is being used. Your family is like an industry only. You can have a problem, you can have a yourself problem, you can have a family problem, which can be settled, which can be improved through the concept of quality circle. So if we can just put it like it's our daily routine, that whatever we do, we'll do with certain discipline, with certain process, with the mindset of improving it on a regular basis. Because you cannot go on following the same process. You have to improve it on a regular basis at the same time. And that's where the Kaizen system comes from, the Japan. That every day try to have some incremental growth, incremental improvement. So whatever we do, our personal life, society as a whole, our industrial life, our hospitality life, wherever entertainment life, wherever you go, you have to have that discipline to be maintained, certain process that need to be followed, that culture we need to create. Once that culture is there, you have set certain standard for your society, for your manufacturing setup, for your entertainment setup, for your hospitality setup, wherever you say. From there, you just try to improve it. Improve in terms of quality of life for each and every person. When the quality of life of each and every person improves, the product made by them is automatically improved. So it has to be a change in mindset. Quality is nothing but change in mindset. That is what I have seen since 80s till today. As I said, in 80s, the concept or my mindset was chalega. 90s, it came, no, you have to change it. And then people started thinking, yes, if I don't change, I don't survive. So it's a change of mindset and mindset towards improvement. So that culture needs to be fostered, need to be taken care in every aspect of life. Once it is done, Kamlesh has told it in so many ways, in simplified ways also, then life will be better, our products will be better. We can do things, produce things not for us only, like pharmaceuticals. People, everybody knows India is actually global hub for pharmaceuticals. And today, everybody looks at pharmaceuticals. Why? Because they have set up a process which is not to be deviated, because they are producing something which directly relates to the health and life of people. And when it is health and life of people, you take more safeguard and see that the processes are really foolproof. Same way for other parts, other areas in our industry life. Today, certain specialty chemicals, if you see, where people across the world, people are looking towards India. Now, because of this Indo-Chinese situation and all, now people are more, in a way, thinking about how we can improve it much more and can export it. Take that opportunity. And that is why I was telling, this is good for India in one way. Of course, it has taken so many lives. It has become miserable for so many people. But it has given a real good opportunity for India to become a real major economical way, a country, to prove the world, yes, we can do. Not just political strength, money strength, economic strength, that we can have. And the main simple thing required is change in mindset. Every aspect need to look at the process part, conformation to the process, a disciplined way of looking at it. And every step, people need to think how I can improve that process, how I can improve that situation so that I can get a better, better product, better output of the total process. So that is how I look at it. Here in LMTG, I also talk to these people, my people, in the same fashion. I don't want any complex way of attacking any problem, because every problem can be attacked in a very, very simplistic manner, in a very simple way, and you will get a very good result. If you make it a complex nature, probably you will be diverted to certain things which is not part of your area, or it can divert it to something else. So look at it in a very simple way. Root cause analysis and the tools that has been given and generated out of many people's brain can also be simplified in your own way, and utilize it wherever you are in your one way. Because copy and paste is a very, very big problem in our society right now that modern generation people, they do. And I always tell my people, yes, copy, paste, right, but I want something else in between C and P, that is called aim. So copy, modify, and paste. And if you can do that, you can be better than Japanese. What actually Japanese people have done? They have not done very great invention or anything. They brought many things from outside, US and other places. They modified it, made it much better, quality-wise, performance-wise, reliability-wise, and then just sold it to those people. That is why I am telling every time, stick to certain process. That is what Japanese philosophy also is. If you have a good, reliable process, don't just like that deviate it. But every day also think how you can do some incremental improvement. So stick to the process, do certain incremental improvement, some innovations, and follow it. Sometimes you can do some breakthrough changes, but not every day. So when this is sustainable, this is done, and this is the culture of a factory, of a company, or any organizations, quality will automatically be very good. That is my thinking process. So the mindset, as Mr. Kamlesh told, yes, how to make the culture. Culture is nothing but the mindset of sum total of people. So we have to change that mindset towards this. Today's generation people, if you see, they are because many people are here who are a little, I mean, age-wise of this generation. So don't take it otherwise. But I have seen they are sometimes not focused at a particular thing. They always divert from one to other, other to other. Today, I was actually in the morning session, I was talking to some GETs who had been taken in L&T Power, of course, through webinar only. I was advising them, kindly use your first 5, 6 years or 10 years in focusing what you are doing. Create a good foundation. After that, jump in and around wherever you want to go, but create your foundation. So same thing I will tell, any company, any organization's foundation, foundation of culture, foundation of certain systems is most important, and regular basis improvement from there is very important. I think QCFI Surat is doing a very, very, commendable job, and thanks to everyone associated with them. And this is one thing, exemplary thing, basically. You are doing it consistently with regular improvement. And this year also, you have come out with this e-presentations and virtual, which has become normal, new normal for everyone. But that's the main thing, because we need to focus on this thing. And that's why hats off to the complete organizations of QCFI, Dungrani Saab, Dr. Latesh, and all the people. You people are doing commendable, real commendable job for improvement of the, because I will not take it just improvement of any organization. It's an improvement and quality improvement of the society as a whole. Because those people, those 48 presenters, if they are really doing it from their heart, definitely their mindset has changed. And one person's mindset will change that entire family mindset. So it's really service to the society. So, congratulations to you, and you are doing commendable job. Thank you, Dungrani Saab, Latesh Saab, and all of you. And once again, I thank you all for having me here. Thank you very much. I'm really glad to be here and honored to be here. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for your enriching and thought-provoking message. I can definitely say a certain concluding word from your side that if you need to establish quality at our end, we need to think on 5 things. We need to be calculative. We need to use right tool, right mindset. We should discipline, and it needs involvement of all. If we are gathering all of these, then we can definitely serve good with our industries and our associates. Now let us conclude the session for collecting more experience and more thoughts with the people. But before we are concluding the session, let's say the vote of thanks. Saying big thanks means telling the other person that will feel affection for you for what all that you are to us. Thank you is a word when it is said with whole heart and soul, it radiates peace love Harman to around us. So I request our joint secretary of UCFI Surat chapter, Mr. Jitendra Vyas sir, to say a lot of thanks. Mr. Jitendra Vyas sir, over to you.
Thank you, Ashish. Hope I am audible.
Yes, sir. You are audible.
Yeah. Thank you, Ashish. Respected chief guest of the day, Alok Sarkar sir, guest of honor, Kamlesh Udani sir, my colleagues on the QCFI dais, and my industry friends. A very knowledgeable person has once said that feeling thankful, not expressing it, is like having a gift wrapped and not giving. So we take this opportunity to express our thankfulness today to the chief guest and the guest of honor to having sparing their time and sharing their valuable inputs with our colleagues and the industry over here. Kamlesh bhai, in his address, very rightly he has said that adversities definitely challenges us, and then that is the way how we can build in quality. And if you see the history of quality in India or in the world, it is the adversities and challenges only which has brought. And I can very well correlate to the examples given by Kamlesh bhai, because I have also been in the pharma and well relate to it. Alok Sarkar sahab has very well brought in the quality scenario and how the young generation of today's time, they should work upon it so that India becomes self-reliant. This is the need of the hour. So from the bottom of my heart, I thank both the dignitaries for having sparing their time, valuable time, giving these inputs. My thanks are also due to although the presentations have not started, but yes, as Dr. Rani Saab has said, 42 presentations will be there. 42 teams have participated. So my thanks are due to all the teams, those who have volunteered and participated into this prestigious convention. We look forward to have some very, very quality discussion, quality concepts over here. So my thanks are due to the participants. Also, special thanks to our judges who will be judging these teams and giving their inputs for the betterment of the projects and further the industry. Last, the most important one is, everyone knows, any team cannot function unless all the team members contribute. So my thanks are also due to all the members of QCFI family over here, those who have put in their efforts for this first e-convention. We have been organizing various other conventions wherein physically we were meeting, but this has been a new experience into new normal due to COVID situation. So everyone has contributed, and the result is before you, and I am hopeful that by the end of the day tomorrow, when we are into the section, we all will have a different experience and various inputs for improving our quality. With these words, I once again express that yes, by the contribution made by the industry, contribution made by the members, we not only will become self-reliant into the matters of quality of industry, but also total quality people will be able to make, which is also one of the motto of QCFI. Thank you. Thank you once again.
Thank you very much, sir, for the vote of thanks. So, as I told you that, let us concluding the session. Thank you very much. Once again, the people are on the screen and off the screen. Now, the next session will be start within very short period of time. You will definitely catch the YouTube link and the other links for the presentation. So, today we have Allied Quality Concepts presentations in two stream yards. So definitely you will enjoy the each and every sessions presented by the company. Thank you very much, one and all. Thank you. You can see the scroll line on your screen that shows you the YouTube link for the QC presentation or today's presentation specially, and we will definitely share the other link for tomorrow presentation also. Thank you very much once again. All the dais, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.